transition that almost created that chance.
Here's Lucas Reichel to Johnson. Korchinski, the shot, turned inside by Wohl. Here's a loose pocket. Oh, man! To the one stop. Wohl's going to pull it back in after a save on Taylor Remish.
Get yourself into that regular season game action. And look at the patience there, not overreacting.
Here's Noah Gregor trying to feed the point. And it's Taylor Hall. He hits in along with Bedard. It drops it off. Pedano. Stop by Wohl. And a rebound. Here's Hall. Back to the line. Jones. Pedano unable to tip that. Cycles it around to the near side. Giordano moves up to the side. Punches from the margin. From the left. Big stop by Sonnenblum.
Get back there. Here's good pinch in by Giordano. Now Tavares knows exactly where Nylander was, but there's a nice save by Soderblom, just keeping his good position. Got the blocker on it.
And now, Bedard trying to pull away. Place burst. Got it from there. In. Forehand and a big stop by Wohl. A rebound in front. And it missed Hall. What a dangerous dash for 98. That deflected wide by Hall. Taylor Hall's on it again. Back to Bedard. At the line. Zaitsev can't get up to the net.
You know, covering the space, he's got his head up the entire way, puts the puck to an area, and uses his feet to get him to the outside. I like the fact that he didn't just go to the outside, he took it harder than the net there, and he tried just to put it back in for him.
Although Corey Perry,
yeah, he's having a chat with Reeves right now, as he yells from the bench.
Now, what Richardson was talking about, how much Corey Perry talks to the referees, and there we go, figure it is going to go. With Connor Murphy. So a response to the hit. Whether they saw it or whether we did or not.
Talking with Reeves, it was on the back end, and there had to have been a discussion before because it wasn't even a hesitation. You know that what will happen on the ice, these guys will come and say, Gregor, you're going to have to deal with the hit that you made, and it's Murphy who drew.
The last time Noah Gregor was in a fight was against Connor Murphy last season.
Now, if you saw those stats there, Harry's got more penalty minutes than Reeves does, 1,300 to just under 1,100, so maybe that was the discussion, who's got more.
So we start the second period, they adjusted the shots, 10-6 in favor of Chicago in that opening period as Barner deflects it inside the line, gets it back again. Two shots for Austin Matthews in that first period. The Key played 130 games as a member of the Blackhawks. Seth Dillon's up ahead. Now can shoot over the line, and it's a goal. Two, after the save, shot by Wohl. Now centering best, and scores! Opens the scoring as the Leafs give up the first goal for the third consecutive game.
The line, as you said, Entwistle comes in, gets his first opportunity of the year. There's a good job coming through the middle of the ice. One good save by Joseph Cuello there, but a chance to clear the puck and a little miscue defensively. Both Finger and the Cage miss their assignment here, a missed stick by both of them, and Entwistle gets that one to post it in.
One more game on the extended road trip to start. Rico Nylander's in to the middle. Drops, scores! It's a beauty for John Tavares on the Nylander side.
Right through training camp through the exhibition. He just took a great move on the line. He turns it around. Now doesn't drop back.
Now Bedard drops it back for Seth Jones.
Just a little hesitation. He had to
put high in the air. Way back and could shoot there for Chicago. Leaned on by Brody. Foligno off the bench. Back to the line. Korchinski with a shot to the net. And now it's been a hit by Lilligren. Corey Perry steps onto the ice. Puck arrives. And now Vlasic for Foligno. Back to Perry. Knocking in. Oh, rebound. And a tandem dangerous burst by William Nylander in behind the net. Nylander tied up there with Jones. And it's sent away. Possession for Toronto to start the third.